हेलो नमस्कार, दिस इज सीवीआर इंग्लिश एंड इट्स नाउ टाइम टू रोल द हेडलाइंस विद मी अनुकृति शर्मा। प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी मीट्स सीएम्स एंड डेप्यूटी सीएम्स ऑफ बीजेपी रूलिंग स्टेट्स एट द पार्टी हेडक्वार्टर्स इन दिल्ली। आम आदमी पार्टी एमपी स्वाति मालीवाल डिमांड जस्टिस फॉर स्टूडेंट्स डेथ इन ओल्ड राजेंद्र नगर, सेज दिल्ली विल नॉट रन लाइक दिस, आई विल रेज दिस इश्यू इन द पार्लियामेंट। इन महाराष्ट्र कोल्हापुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट रिलीफ फोर्स कैरीज आउट रिलीफ वर्क एज फ्लड लाइक सिचुएशन कंटिन्यूज इन द एरिया। In Hyderabad, Telangana Minister Komati Reddy Venkat Reddy visited the Bhagyalakshmi Temple and offered prayers ahead of the Bonnalu Festival. And now we have the live visuals all the way from our Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman's press meet. Let's take a look.
Between 2009 and 14, allocation for railways in 24-25 budget, please listen to this carefully. I said 9 to 14 was 835 crores. Now this budget allocates 7,559 crores for Karnataka. For railways alone, you heard the earlier number, na?
Okay.
9 to 14, it was 835 crores. Now, in 24-25, in this budget alone, 7,559 crores. Just to give you breakdown of some of the projects, ongoing projects for laying new tracks, 31 projects are ongoing. 3,840 kilometer rail tracks are being laid, 3,840 kilometers, and so what is the value of the ongoing projects? 47,016 crores only for railways in Karnataka for the existing new ongoing projects. Since 2014, to understand how this works out, 638 railway flyovers have been built, railways flyover. 7 Vande Bharat trains have been operationalized. I'm sure I don't need to tell you the destinations and the route, you know about it. So that's about railways alone. I'll quickly move on to the other major decisions where central funds come and they set up IIT Dharwad, March 23. First industrial corridor for South India was inaugurated by Prime Minister in Tumkur, because that is a part of the Chennai-Bangalore corridor. There are other three nodes. One is in Tumkur, Karnataka. Another is Krishnapatnam in Andhra Pradesh. A third one is Ponneri in Tamil Nadu. But this Tumkur got inaugurated by PM. 7 cities in Karnataka have been selected for smart cities, you know it. More than, I'm giving you amount, please write it down. More than 6,428 crores have been given to Karnataka, money already released for smart city mission. 904 projects worth 15,000 crore work orders have been issued already. Work orders are already issued. So what is given to Karnataka? Amount is given, work is happening, orders have been placed on the ground, it is moving. So I want you to please take, ma'am, you want something? You want me to repeat the number? Okay. Then come over, because of all these policies, and because of the favorable environment we tried to create in the center and state government also, you had in January 2024 Boeing India, which is a private company, I'm not taking credit for it, but because the larger policies are all favorable, Boeing India Engineering and Technology Center built its biggest campus in Bengaluru. That's their biggest outside of US. Nobody, nowhere else. They didn't go to China, they didn't go to any other country. They came and set it up here. And that is an investment of 1,600 crores. These things don't happen in isolation. If policy support, other opening up with Government of India supporting in FDI rules, investments come. I quickly move over to roadways for Karnataka. 4,600 kilometer roads have been constructed already. NDA government has invested more than 1 lakh crore in highways related projects in Karnataka only in the recent years. Just for highway related, the total money which has come is over 1 lakh crores. Okay, many greenfield corridors are being built under Bharat Mala Pariyojana Phase 1. I'll just name three of them. Bengaluru Chennai Expressway, Bengaluru Ring Road, Solapur Karnool Chennai Corridor. These three are happening under the roads. Then of course air connectivity, 7 operationalized airports under Udaan. All of them are nicely getting modernized. Then you know the newly constructed Shivamogga Airport has been inaugurated in February 23. Also in March, the foundation stone for a new terminal building in Hubli and Belgavi have been established. Now if all this is the side of the central government, without going into details because you are all people in the ground here, what is the state government's contribution? High inflation, much higher than the national average. And how am I saying that? Inflation between June 23 and June 24, the national average was 5.4%. Karnataka is at 6.1%. Okay? And what's the contrast within Karnataka? Between June 22 and May 23, Karnataka was lower than the national average. What was the national average at that time? 6%. But Karnataka kept its inflation rate at 5.39%. So there was a year, not too far away, when inflation was lesser in Karnataka than the national average. But now inflation is higher than the national average. You know the reasons for it. I'll highlight the reasons. Petrol price was hiked by 3 rupees for petrol and 3.5 for diesel. Milk prices have gone up by 5 rupees. Property guidance value has been hiked from 25% to 30%. Stamp duty charges have increased by 200 to 500.
So those were the live visuals from the press meet, the ongoing press meet where our finance minister, central finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman, is speaking about the union budget. Moving on, Prime Minister Narendra Modi chaired a meeting of chief ministers and deputy chief ministers of the BJP ruled states at the party headquarters in Delhi on Sunday. Senior leaders including union ministers such as Amit Shah, Rajnath Singh and JP Nadda, who is also the BJP national president, attended this meeting. Rajasthan Chief Minister Bhajan Lal Sharma, Tripura Chief Minister Manik Saha, Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Mohan Kumar Yadav, Manipur Chief Minister N. Biren Singh and Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, along with Gujarat Chief Minister Bhupendra Patel, Uttarakhand Chief Minister Pushkar Singh Dhami, Assam Chief Minister Himant Biswa Sharma, Goa Chief Minister Pramod Sawant, Chhattisgarh Chief Minister Vishnu Deo, Sai Arunachal Pradesh Chief Minister Prem Khandu and Odisha Chief Minister Mohan Charan Majhi, amongst others, were present at this meeting. Maharashtra Deputy Chief Minister Devendra Fadnis, Uttar Pradesh Deputy Chief Minister Keshav Prasad Maurya, Nagaland Deputy Chief Minister Y. Patton, Bihar Deputy Chief Minister Samrat Chaudhary and Vijay Kumar Sinha and Rajasthan Deputy Chief Minister Diya Kumari, amongst others, also attended this meeting. Let's take a look. Union Minister Chirag Paswan's statement addresses the controversy surrounding the Niti Aayog meeting and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee's actions. He denies allegations that anyone's microphone was switched off during this meeting, dismissing such claims as utterly false. Paswan criticizes Mamata Banerjee's decision to aggressively leave the meeting, describing her behavior as inappropriate. He suggests that her actions appeared to be a part of a calculated strategy by the opposition to create chaos and to attract attention. Paswan emphasizes that Niti Aayog is a forum where states can voice their grievances and address any perceived injustices. His remarks reflected the political discourse surrounding the Niti Aayog meeting, highlighting differing perspectives on the conduct of the participating leaders and the purpose of such a high-level gathering for state and central government coordination.
देखिए उस बैठक में नीति आयोग की उस बैठक में मैं भी मौजूद था और ये सरासर गलत इल्जाम है कि किसी का माइक वहां पे बंद कर दिया गया। पहली बात तो जब ये विपक्ष बोलता है कि माइक बंद कर दे, उस माइक का कंट्रोल वहां पे बैठे किसी भी व्यक्ति के हाथ में नहीं होता है, उस व्यक्ति के खुद के हाथ में होता है, ना लोकसभा में, ना राज्यसभा में, ना ऐसी किसी बैठकों में। ऐसी बैठक में माइक सामने लगा होता है, ऑन ऑफ का स्विच सामने ही होता है। तो ये बात बोलना सरासर झूठ है जब कोई ये बोलता है कि मेरा माइक बंद कर दिया गया। हाँ, हर मुख्यमंत्री को, क्योंकि समय की बाध्यता थी, ओपन एंडेड अगर डिस्कशन को रखा जाता तो संभवतः हफ्तों तक ये बैठक ही चलती रहती। ऐसे में हर मुख्यमंत्री से ये विनम्रता पूर्वक आग्रह किया गया था कि अपनी बातों को संक्षेप में एक तय समय सीमा के भीतर रखा जाए। जब वो समय सीमा पूरी हुई, सिर्फ एक रिमाइंडर के तौर पर उनको जरूर, जैसे तमाम मुख्यमंत्री को दोबारा से नोटिफाई किया गया कि भाई आपका समय समाप्त हो रहा है इस तरीके से, बट उसके बाद जिस तरीके से बंगाल की मुख्यमंत्री ममता बनर्जी जी एकदम से उत्तेजित होकर उस
Mayor Shelley Oberoi's response to the tragic incident at the coaching center in Old Rajinder Nagar in New Delhi conveys several key points. Condolences and immediate action is one. She expresses sadness over the loss of three lives and emphasizes the need for swift action. Oberoi has written to the MCD commissioner to take strict action against the coaching centers across Delhi that violate these building bylaws, specifically those using basements for commercial activities contrary to regulations. Building certification and violations happens to be number two on the agenda. Oberoi mentions that the building in Rajinder Nagar where the incident occurred was certified in 2021 with specific guidelines that the basement should only be used for parking and storage. This suggests that the coaching center's use of the basement for other purposes may have violated these clear stipulations. Number three was focus on accountability. She urges against playing the blame game and stresses the importance of holding responsible parties accountable for any lapses or violations that contributed to such a strategy. Let's take a look.
नगर में जो बस में दुर्घटना हुई राजेंद्र नगर, तीन बच्चों की मौत हो चुकी है, उसमें किसे जिम्मेदार मानती है आप? जो सवाल उठ रहे हैं कि एमसीडी की पूरी जिम्मेदारी थी, वहाँ पे डिसिल्टिंग नहीं हुई थी, पानी का बहाव जो आया उसमें बच्चे डूब गए।
देखिए, कल एक बहुत ही दुखद घटना हुई। राजेंद्र नगर के एक कोचिंग सेंटर की बेसमेंट में पानी भर गया और कुछ बच्चे ट्रैप हो गए। जैसे ही मुझे इस घटनाक्रम का पता लगा, मैं मौके पर पहुंची। वहां पर देखा कि एनडीआरएफ की टीम जो है ऑलरेडी रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशन कर रही थी। और ये सबसे दुख की बात है कि तीन बच्चों की मौत हो गई। और अब जैसे ही इस घटना के बाद, अब मैंने कमिश्नर एमसीडी को एक लेटर लिखा है जिसमें आप देख सकते हैं कि हमने दो निर्देश मैंने दिए हैं। पहला, दिल्ली में जितने भी कोचिंग सेंटर्स हैं जो उन बिल्डिंग्स में चल रहा है जो एमसीडी की जुरिस्डिक्शन में आते हैं, और बेसमेंट में बायलॉज के अगेंस्ट या नॉर्म्स के अगेंस्ट ऐसे कोचिंग सेंटर चल रहे हैं, उन पर सख्त से सख्त कार्रवाई हो, उन पर एक्शन लिया जाए। दूसरा, और अगर इस मामले में जो कल राजेंद्र नगर में हुआ, कोई भी एमसीडी अधिकारी अगर जिम्मेदार है तो उस पर भी सख्त कार्रवाई की जाए। मैं आपको बताना चाहती हूँ इस बिल्डिंग के बारे में। ये जो बिल्डिंग है, इसका जो कंप्लीशन सर्टिफिकेट 2021 में मिला था और साफ साफ यहाँ लिखा है कि बेसमेंट में पार्किंग यूज और स्टोरेज के लिए और कार लिफ्ट के लिए यूज होगा। तो मैं बताना चाहती हूँ कि अगर इस प्रकार से इलीगल तरीके से या प्रॉपर्टी को मिसयूज कर अगर ऐसे कोचिंग सेंटर्स बेसमेंट में चल रहे हैं तो उन पर कार्रवाई होगी, और साथ ही अगर कोई अधिकारी जिम्मेदार होगा उस पर भी सख्त से सख्त कार्रवाई होगी।
लेकिन जो सवाल उठ रहे हैं मैम की एमसीडी की कार्यप्रणाली पे, कि एमसीडी को इस तरह से प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स आप लोग लेते हैं, उसकी जिम्मेदारी वहाँ पे जाकर जांच करना, उन्हें सर्टिफिकेट देना, जो एनओसी देना, सब एमसीडी की जिम्मेदारी है। साथ में जो हादसा हुआ, जो पानी वहाँ पे पहुंचा, उसकी भी जिम्मेदारी एमसीडी की बनती है।
देखिए, बताया जा रहा था कि बिल्डिंग के आगे से कोई ड्रेन या कोई सीवर जो निकलता है वो एकदम से फट गया। मैं मौके पर पहुंची और वहां देखा कि आसपास की बिल्डिंग में पानी नहीं भरा और कुछ वो सीवर या ड्रेन टूटने से फ्लैश फ्लड की तरह जो है वो जो पानी है सारा बेसमेंट में भर गया, और जिसके कारण बेसमेंट में पानी भरने से बच्चे ट्रैप हो गए।
अभी जो आपने बताया कि 2021 नगर में जो घटना दुर्घटना हुई राजेंद्र नगर की,
Swati Maliwal, an Aam Aadmi Party MP, has strongly criticized the Delhi government and other officials in response to the tragic incident at a coaching center in Old Rajinder Nagar in New Delhi, highlighting several demands and concerns regarding the handling of the situation. Demand for an FIR against the government officials, Maliwal has demanded, yes, and I quote, that an FIR should be registered against all the big government officials whom she holds responsible for this incident. She perceives the deaths as a result of negligence rather than a natural disaster. Compensation for families is next. She has called for a compensation of rupees 1 crore to be provided to the families of each deceased student, emphasizing the gravity of the loss suffered by the victims' families. And next is criticism of absent officials. Maliwal criticized the absence of the Delhi government ministers, the mayor of MCD, which is the Municipal Corporation of Delhi, and other officials from the site, despite more than 12 hours being passed since the incident occurred. She believes that their presence and apology are absolutely necessary in the light of this tragedy. And then commitment to raise this issue in the parliament. She pledged to raise the students' demands and the incident itself in the parliament, ensuring that the issue receives national attention and accountability is sought from the responsible authorities. Next on her agenda is allegations of prior warning. Maliwal mentioned that students had reportedly informed the local councillor about the poor drainage system in the area 12 days prior to this incident. She holds the councillor and higher authorities accountable for not addressing these concerns adequately. Let's take a look.
गुस्से में है, 12 घंटे से ज्यादा हो गए हैं। अभी तक ना तो दिल्ली सरकार का कोई मंत्री आया है, ना ही एमसीडी की मेयर आई है, कोई अधिकारी नहीं आया है। मैं ये मानती हूँ कि ये जो मौत हुई है ये कोई डिजास्टर नहीं है, ये सीधे सीधे मर्डर है। ये जितने भी सरकार के बहुत बड़े बड़े नुमाइंदे हैं, इन सब पे FIR होनी चाहिए, सबकी जिम्मेदारी बनती है। जितने बच्चे मरे हैं उन सबके घर में जाकर 1 करोड़ की कॉम्पनसेशन इंडिविजुअली देनी चाहिए। बच्चे बहुत दुखी हैं और बहुत गुस्से में हैं, और क्यों ना हो, 12 घंटे से ज्यादा हो गए हैं। अभी तक ना तो दिल्ली सरकार का कोई मंत्री आया है, ना ही MCD की मेयर आई है, कोई अधिकारी नहीं आया है, इन बच्चों को अपने हाल पे छोड़ा हुआ है। मैं ये मानती हूँ कि ये जो मौत हुई है ये कोई डिजास्टर नहीं है, ये सीधे सीधे मर्डर है। FIR दर्ज होनी चाहिए। ये जितने भी सरकार के बहुत बड़े बड़े नुमाइंदे हैं, इन सब पे FIR होनी चाहिए, सबकी जिम्मेदारी बनती है, नंबर 1। नंबर 2, ये बच्चे देश के अलग अलग कोनों से UPSC की तैयारी करने दिल्ली आते हैं, बहुत बड़े बड़े सपने लेकर आते हैं। इनके माँ बाप कैसे कैसे कर इन्हें दिल्ली भेजते हैं, और उसके बाद इन बच्चों की इतनी दर्दनाक मौत होगी और कोई एक्शन नहीं लिया जाएगा। सबसे जरूरी है, ये जितने भी बच्चे मरे हैं, अभी तो पता ही नहीं चल पा रहा कि 3 मरे हैं या ज्यादा मरे हैं, जितने बच्चे मरे हैं उन सबके घर में जाकर 1 करोड़ की कॉम्पनसेशन इंडिविजुअली देनी चाहिए। और तीसरी बात, ये जो मंत्री और मेयर, और मेयर ने तो भी कुछ दिन पहले बोला था कि मॉनसून आने वाला है, दिल्ली वाले इंजॉय कीजिए, ये इंजॉयमेंट है? ये जितने भी लोग हैं इन्हें यहाँ आना चाहिए, मंत्री को तुरंत आना चाहिए, मेयर को तुरंत आना चाहिए, इन बच्चों का गुस्सा झेलना चाहिए और इनसे माफी मांगनी चाहिए। ऐसे दिल्ली नहीं चलेगी, दिल्ली देश की राजधानी है।
In Telangana's Hyderabad, Union Minister G. Kishan Reddy and his family offered prayers at the Mahakali Temple in Ambarpet. Let's take a look at these visuals from CVR English. Venkat Reddy's visit to the Bhagyalakshmi Temple in Hyderabad underscores his religious observance and engagement with local religious communities. Offering prayers at the temple is a gesture of reverence and cultural connection, highlighting his respect for religious traditions and the significance of this temple in the community. Such visits by political leaders often serve to strengthen ties with the constituents and demonstrate support for the local religious institutions. They also provide an opportunity for leaders to connect with religious sentiments and issues that are important to their constituents. Overall, Venkat Reddy's visit to the Bhagyalakshmi Temple reflects his engagement with the religious and the cultural fabric of Telangana, emphasizing the role of such visits in the political and community relations.
బాగా లేక ఫ్యాక్టరీల వేస్టేజ్ వదిలిపెట్టి ఎవరు పట్టించుకోలే. గతంలో 7 లక్షల కోట్లు అప్పు చేసినా 30,000 కోట్లు పెడితే ఇలా మూసీలో పక్క నుంచి మన హోటల్స్ పెట్టుకోవడం, విహారయాత్ర లాగా టూరిస్టులు వచ్చే విధంగా హైదరాబాద్ టూరిస్టులు ఇప్పటికే పెరుగుతారు. చార్మినార్ కానీ అమ్మవారిని దర్శించుకుంటాను కానీ ఇది చాలా ఫేమస్ది. అలాంటి టూరిజం పాయింట్ లాగా మూసీని చేయబోతున్నాం. వచ్చే 3-4 సంవత్సరాలను పూర్తి చేయాలన్నదే మా లక్ష్యం. మెట్రో కూడా 3 సంవత్సరాలు, ఈ 10,000 కోట్లతోని పేదవాళ్ళందరికీ ఇళ్ళు కట్టించే కార్యక్రమాలు కూడా చేసుకుంటూ, ముఖ్యంగా ఉస్మానియా హాస్పిటల్ని ఈరోజు ఆల్ పార్టీ వాళ్ళు గత ప్రభుత్వం ఉన్నప్పుడు సంతకాలు పెట్టి ఒప్పుకున్నారు, అదే డిజైన్లో కట్టాలని మేము కూడా నిర్ణయించుకున్నాం. అది కూడా మా R&B డిపార్ట్మెంట్తోనే త్వరలోనే ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారి ఆధ్వర్యంలో వారితో చర్చించడం, ఇప్పటికే 2-3 సార్లు మీటింగ్స్ అయినాయి. ఉస్మానియా హాస్పిటల్ ఫేస్ లో అదే డిజైన్ తో కొత్త ఉస్మానియా హాస్పిటల్ రాబోతున్నది. అన్ని వసతులతో కూడిన హైదరాబాద్ లో 5 హాస్పిటల్ పెద్దగా కడుతున్నాం, 4 ఎల్వి నగర్, అల్వాల్, సనత్ నగర్, నిమ్స్ లో. కానీ ఉస్మానియా ఉంటేనే ఈ ప్రాంత పేద ప్రజలందరూ కూడా అందుబాటులో ఉంటుంది. కాబట్టి దాని మీద కూడా డిజైన్స్ చర్చలు ప్రారంభమైనాయి. అది కూడా నా ఆర్ఎన్బి శాఖ ద్వారానే ఉస్మానియా హాస్పిటల్ కూడా కట్టబోతున్నాం. మరొకసారి భాగ్యలక్ష్మి అమ్మవారి ఆశీస్సులతోని ప్రజలందరూ క్షేమంగా ఉండాలని, ఎలాంటి ఇబ్బందులు లేకుండా ఉండాలని. వచ్చే 4 ఏళ్ళు కాదు, ఇంకో 5 ఏళ్ళు కాదు, ఇంకో 10 ఏళ్ళు కాదు, ఇదే ఇందిరమ్మ రాజ్యం ఉంటుంది, మీకు అందరికీ అండగా ఉంటుంది. భాగ్యలక్ష్మి అమ్మవారి ఆశీస్సులు కూడా ఉండాలని మరొకసారి అమ్మవారిని.
In Maharashtra, particularly in the Kolhapur district, the disaster relief force has been actively engaged in the relief operations due to a flood-like situation in the area. This response comes as heavy rains have led to the rising water levels and inundation, affecting local communities and the infrastructure. The disaster relief force, along with the local authorities and volunteers, is focused on providing immediate assistance to the affected residents. The efforts typically include rescue operations, providing shelter to the displaced individuals, distributing essential supplies such as food and clean water, and offering medical assistance to those in need. Floods and similar natural disasters pose significant challenges to regions such as Kolhapur, necessitating swift and coordinated relief efforts to mitigate damage and support the affected populations. The ongoing relief work underscores the importance of the preparedness and effective response measures in safeguarding communities during such emergencies. Let's take a look at these visuals. And before we close for this agenda, let's look at the headlines once again. PM Modi meets CMs and Deputy CMs of the BJP ruled states at the party headquarters in Delhi. Aam Aadmi Party MP Swati Maliwal demands justice for student's death in old Rajinder Nagar, says Delhi will not run like this. I will raise this issue in the parliament. In Maharashtra's Kolhapur district, relief force carries out relief work as flood-like situation continues in the area. In Hyderabad, Telangana Minister Komati Reddy Venkat Reddy visited the Bhagyalakshmi temple and offered prayers ahead of the Bonnalu festival. And that's all for this afternoon's Bulletin's agenda. This is Anukriti Sharma signing off. Keep watching CVR English.